वेलकम व्यूअर्स एंड डियर लर्नर्स टू माई चैनल लर्निंग इंग्लिश विथ अमोल. दिस इज़ द फोर्थ वीडियो अबाउट द टॉपिक एक्टिव एंड पैसिव वॉइस. टॉपिक फॉर दिस वीडियो इज हाउ टू कन्वर्ट एन एक्टिव सेंटेंस इन टू पैसिव वॉइस बट ऑफ द sentences in continuous tense form. Earlier sentences which we took for our activities, most of those were in either simple present or simple past tense, and few examples were picked up from modal auxiliaries. Now this video is all about how to convert the sentence in continuous tense form into passive voice. Let us take the first example. I am preparing a delicious cake. As it is labeled, I as a subject, am as to be's representative for present, and afterwards preparing. The original verb is prepare, which is joined with ing, so v1 plus ing, prepare plus ing is equal to preparing a delicious cake. As usually, the question is asked what to the action verb preparing. So preparing what, the answer to this question is cake, a delicious cake. Now all our ideas about the very role of every single word there in a sentence is clear. So without making any mistake, we can start with an object, a delicious cake, in place of subject. A delicious cake, afterwards to be's representative is, it is kept there. Later on, be plus ing, being, which is kept duly to maintain the continuous tense form, and later on action verb preparing is converted there into past participle form prepared, and finally the subject I, which is in pronoun form, is converted into its second form and is associated with by me. A delicious cake is being prepared by me. This is how the continuous tense assertive sentence is converted into passive voice. Another example is, I was wearing a red scarf. This is a sentence which is picked up from a lesson of 11th standard. I was wearing a red scarf. So this sentence is of past continuous tense. As usually, it is labeled subject, then to be's form, then wear plus ing, wearing, and again a question what. The answer to this question is a red scarf. So object a red scarf is kept in place of subject. Later on, to be's representative was and were, out of which was is chosen, as a red scarf is representing singular number. Afterwards, being is put there duly just to identify or to denote continuous tense, because every action verb, may it be in first form, second form, having the ing form, it is always going to get converted into past participle form. So wear, wore, worn. So here it is worn, w-o-r-n, and finally by, I is replaced by me, by me. A red scarf was being worn by me. This is how past continuous tense sentence is converted into passive voice. One more example is Indian Army is keeping high alert guard on border. As usually it is labeled, and finally it is again converted there into passive construction. High alert guard is an object of the given sentence, so it is kept at the front. Is again a representative of to be for present. Later on, again the very specific identity or specific feature of passive construction of continuous tense is being, b plus ing, being is kept, and later on keeping is converted into kept, because I made it clear that every action verb is always converted into past participle form. So kept is there, and finally the subject is associated with by, and as it is in proper noun, so it is not changed, or it is kept as it is, Indian Army, by Indian Army. So high alert guard is being kept by Indian Army. This is how we have seen three examples of present and past continuous tense and its passive structure. Let us see what exactly is followed. Dear students, here is the structure for passive construction for continuous tense sentences. At the first place, object will be kept. Afterwards, to be's representative as per the demand of the tense form. If it is in present, am, is, are, and past, was, were, out of which one which is suitable for that object will be kept. Later on, being, this is a word which you will uniquely find there in the passive construction of only continuous tense form sentences. So please keep it in mind that being will be a part and parcel of this sentence. Afterwards, your action verb in the active sentence, of course with ing, will be converted into past participle form. Thereafter, if any complement is there, you can put it either after it or even at the end of the sentence. And finally, it is attached by plus your subject of the sentence. This is how you have to maintain the structure for passive construction of the sentences in continuous tense form, only for present continuous and past continuous. Here is an example to differentiate and find why being is introduced there in the continuous tense sentences. Here is the example which is in simple present tense form, and afterwards the same sentence but only in present continuous tense form. Let us see closely. Sentence is, I prepare a delicious cake. Subject plus V1, of course it is simple present. As usually, question what, and answer is a delicious cake. So it is an object. As usually, an object is kept at the first place, a delicious cake. Later on, to be's form is, and action verb in its past participle form prepared, and finally by, I is converted into me. Until this, I hope everybody has understood. Now, how to differentiate between the passive construction of simple present and present continuous? That's the matter of this discussion. Second sentence is, I am preparing a delicious cake. Here the structure is S plus to be plus V1 plus ing. After I, there is an auxiliary am, and later on action verb having ing. So this is the significant feature of continuous tense. Now, the similar procedure is followed by asking the question what to the action verb, and the answer to this is a delicious cake. So a delicious cake, which is an object, is kept as it is at the first place, later on, keeping the tense form in view, to be's representative is kept there. But as we know that this action verb preparing, we cannot keep it in the same form, so we have to convert it into past participle form. In the earlier sentence also, is prepared is there, you can see here is prepared. And if I put it in the same way without being, so the structure of the passive structure of simple present and past continuous would look almost alike. So to differentiate, we have to put being, be plus ing, consciously and duly, so that we can make the slight difference between these two sentences. A delicious cake is being prepared by me. Otherwise, you can see that a delicious cake is there in the earlier sentence, again here. Then is there, again is here. Prepared, here also prepared by me. The only word which is additional therein, that is being. Why we kept being there? Just to make it clear that the given sentence is in continuous tense form. I hope you have understood it well, and your idea about the structure of passive construction of the continuous tense is quite clear. Now, this is all about the very method which we have applied for this activity. The only thing which I would like to read out here is that put being as a representative of continuous tense, which is very important. Otherwise, rest of the entire procedure is as it is, which we learned in the earlier video also. Now, here are some examples for you to solve. We are making a pact. He is offering silent prayer. Colonel Hunt was giving me 3 flags. She was painting a beautiful sketch. And last one, farmers were plowing farms before monsoon. This is an exercise for you all. I appeal you all, please try to solve these 5 questions, and you try to pick out some more there from your text and even from the non-textual part also. If you like this video, please like it, mark it liked, then share it with your friends and relatives, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, Learning English with Amol. Thank you, dear students.